إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم تسليمًا كثيرًا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله. Indeed, the most truthful of speech is the book of Allah. وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. And the best guidance is the guidance of our beloved messenger Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. وشر الأمور محدثاتها. And the worst of affairs are those things we newly invent into this religion of ours. وكل محدثة بدعة. And everything we newly invent into this religion of ours is an innovation. وَكُلَّ بِدْعَةٍ ضَلَالَةٍ. And every innovation is misguidance and it leads astray. وَكُلَّ ضَلَالَةٍ فِي النَّارِ. And every going astray, every misguidance is in the hellfire. ثُمَّ أَمَّا بَعْدٍ. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, year after year, this issue comes up. And sadly, although it is a clear innovation, we find it still being practiced and propagated by many Muslims across the globe. You will see the titles of Mawlid, or the prophetic journey, or the virtual Mawlid, or Rasul week, and the likes of these matters. And you might see it as a small thing, but really it is a grand, major innovation that we would commit. First, we don't know if the date of the birth of our Prophet ﷺ is accurate. And secondly, we know as Muslims that we have two Eids. Eid al-Adha and Eid al-Fitr. The day of sacrifice and the day of feasting after the month of Ramadan. Celebrating anything other than those two, even the birth of our Prophet ﷺ, is an innovation and it should not be done. Let's look at the ayat and the hadith. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said, وَنَزَّلْنَا عَلَيْكَ الْكِتَابَ تِبْيَانًا لِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said, what means, and we sent down to you the book, the Qur'an, as an exposition and an explanation for everything. ثُمَّ قَالَ اللَّهُ مَا فَرَّطْنَا فِي الْكِتَابِ مِنْ شَيْءٍ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, what means, and we did not neglect anything. Nothing was neglected from this book, from this Qur'an that was sent down to you. ثُمَّ قَالَ اللَّهُ قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهُ فَاتَّبِعُونِي يُحْبِبُكُمُ اللَّهُ وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبُكُمْ. And Allah said, what means, say, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, indeed, if you love Allah, if you love Allah and want to please Him and earn His pleasure, then follow me, follow the sunnah, the guidance of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and then Allah will love you and forgive you your sins. ثُمَّ قَالَ اللَّهُ الْيَوْمَ أَكْمَلْتُ لَكُمْ دِينُكُمْ وَأَتْمَمْتُ عَلَيْكُمْ نِعْمَتِي وَرَضِيتُ لَكُمْ الْإِسْلَامَ دِينًا. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said, what means, this day I have perfected your religion for you and completed my favor upon you and have chosen for you al-Islam as your religion. ثُمَّ قَالَ اللَّهُ وَمَنْ يُطِعِ الرَّسُولَ فَقَدْ أَطَاعَ اللَّهَ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, what means, and whoever obeys Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and follows his sunnah, then this person has obeyed Allah. ثُمَّ قَالَ اللَّهُ وَمَا آتَاكُمُ الرَّسُولُ فَخُذُوهُ وَمَا نَهَاكُمْ عَنْهُ فَانْتَهُوا. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, what means, and whatever the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gives you, take it and follow it. And whatever he prohibits you from, then stay away from it. ثُمَّ قَالَ اللَّهُ وَمَا يَنْطِقُ عَنِ الْهَوَىٰ إِنْ هُوَ إِلَّا وَحْيٌ يُوحَىٰ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that the Messenger, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, does not speak out of his own desire, out of his own whim, out of his own thought, out of his own intellect. Indeed, he is speaking and giving you a revelation revealed. وَقَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ مَنْ عَمِلَ عَمِلًا لَيْسَ عَلَيْهِ أَمْرُنَا فَهُوَ رَدْ. Our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, whoever does any action not legislated in this deen, not from these actions of ours, not from something sent down from Allah or given to you by His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, then that action is going to be rejected, even if you think it's good. Even if it has goodness in your eyes along with it, it will be rejected. ثُمَّ قَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ مَنْ أَحْدَثَ فِي أَمْرِنَا هَذَا مَا لَيْسَ مِنْهُ فَهُوَ رَدْ. And whoever speaks a word, speaks something that was not legislated in this religion of ours, then it is going to be rejected. ثُمَّ قَالَ رَسُولُ Those hadith were in Bukhari and Muslim. ثُمَّ قَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ لَا يُؤْمِنُ عَبْدٌ حَتَّى أَكُونَ أَحَبَّ إِلَيْهِ مِنْ أَهْلِهِ وَمَالِهِ وَالنَّاسِ أَجْمَعِينَ. رواه مسلم. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, a servant does not completely and truly believe till I, meaning the Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, is more beloved to him than his family, than his wealth, than all of mankind. ثم قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم لا تطروني كما أطرت النصارى ابن مريم فإنما أنا عبدهم فقولوا عبد الله ورسوله. And our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said in the authentic hadith, do not exaggerate in praising me as the Christians have the son of Mary, Isa, Prophet Jesus alayhi salam. For indeed I am Allah's slave and servant, so call me Allah's messenger, Allah's servant and his messenger. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, in a nutshell, those were some ayat and ahadith that fortify the fact that we should not be celebrating the birth of our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That rather what was commanded of us was to follow the deen as it was revealed. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam did not order the celebrating of his birth. The Sahaba radiallahu anhum wa ardahum, the ones, may Allah be pleased with them, who loved the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam more than we did, who were so keen to give up their life and their wealth to support Islam, to support and protect the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, because of their love for Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The Sahaba, may Allah be pleased with them, they did not celebrate it. The four A'imma, Imam Abu Hanifa, Imam Malik, Imam Shafi'i, Imam Ahmad, rahimahumullah, may Allah have mercy on them. None of them supported this celebration of the birth, and this wasn't even a thought in their time. Part of these two generations after the Sahaba, no one was found celebrating the birth of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and that was the best of generations. كما قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم خير الناس قرني ثم الذين يلونهم ثم الذين يلونهم. Our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the one who said, the best of mankind is my generation, meaning me and my companions. Then those who follow them, the tabi'in. Then those who follow them, the tabi'in. And if none of them were seen or heard of celebrating the Mawlid or the birth of the Prophet ﷺ, then who are we to think that it is part of this deen? That we have a different way of loving our Prophet ﷺ that they didn't know of or they didn't think of. So how do we celebrate his birth when we don't value and cherish and live the message he came with? How do you celebrate his birth? How do you celebrate his birth when we do not value and cherish and live the message that he came with? How do you feel if someone showed you love only one day of the year and pretty much ignored you the rest of that year? We claim to love him, but the question is, do we really love him? Ikhwani akhwati fillah, he came with the message of Tawheed. عَبَدَ اللَّهَ رَبِّي وَرَبُّكُمْ. Worship Allah, my Lord and your Lord. That Allah is one and all worship is only dedicated to Him. Yet many of us have, whether it be through cultural ignorance or whatever it may be, shirk in our lives, in our homes. Is it so much for you to give away or get rid of or trash or break that blue eye you hang in your home? Or to get rid of that thing on your wrist or hung up in your car or around your neck that you think protects you when in no way does it protect you? He came with the message of Tawheed and you say you love him, but we can't get rid of the shirk that we have. The salah, أول ما يسأل به العبد من عمله يوم القيامة. The first thing that the slave will be asked about on the day of resurrection, it will be his prayers. If it is good and sound, the rest of him will be good and sound. If it is corrupt, the rest of him will be corrupt. Our Prophet ﷺ in his last days, his final words that he kept repeating and repeating, As-salah, as-salah wa ma malakat aymanukum, the prayer, and that which your right hands possess. The prayer, always pushing to the prayer. Yet we have many who claim they love the Prophet ﷺ, celebrate his day of birth, and they abandon the prayer. The prayer that he, ﷺ, he said, وَمَنْ تَرَكَهَا فَقَدْ كَفَرَ. The one who leaves off the prayer has committed kufr, has committed disbelief. This is the prayer. The one that our Prophet ﷺ said, جُعَلَتْ قُرَّةَ عَيْنِي فِي الصَّلَاةِ. That the beauty and the coolness of my eyes has been made in the salah, in the prayer. This is what our Prophet ﷺ came with. How do we claim to love him when we abandon that? How do we claim to love him when we abandon the salah? The zakat and the siyam, also things that were legislated upon us that we abandon. Cheating our ways out of paying the zakat on our wealth. Fasting Ramadan aimlessly with no achievement of the taqwa it was supposed to come with. كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الصِّيَامُ كَمَا كُتِبَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. Fasting was prescribed upon us not to get fit, not to just do the action and return to evil, but for us to achieve taqwa. For us to get closer to our Lord, to fear Him, to keep our duty to Him, to put a barrier between us and the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Hajj, the pilgrimage, who many people delay, but they indulge at this time in the dunya. They'll say that the Hajj costs too much money, but they'll spend thousands on aimless things. From a funeral to a wedding, from a car to a home, to things beyond their excess, delaying the Hajj, the pilgrimage due on them once in their lifetime, while they're able to do this. All of this, and we dare to celebrate his birthday and his life, but not follow his sunnah. So there's no true celebration of the Prophet ﷺ's birth, his life, his message, and what he came with, except implementing the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Following the Qur'an and acting upon it. Following the commands of the Prophet ﷺ. Doing what he commanded and staying away from what he forbade. Taking extra proof and evidence from how the Sahaba radiallahu anhum arudahum, how they lived that message. The Prophet ﷺ, كَانَ خُلْقُهُ الْقُرْآنِ. His character was the Qur'an. This is how he lived his life. The best of character, the best of morals, the best of manners. So you must correct yourself with it. How many times did he stress the importance that the one whose character is good, he reaches darajat as-sa'im al-qa'im. He reaches the level of the one who prays, who fasts every day and prays the night. That we know that the Prophet ﷺ, he said, مَا مِنْ شَيْءٍ أَثْقَلُ فِي الْمِيزَانِ يَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ مِنْ حُسْنِ الْخُلُقِ. That there is nothing heavier on your scales on the day of resurrection. On the day of resurrection, nothing will be heavier on your scales than your good manners and your good character. And yet we find, unfortunately, the Muslims sometimes having the most wicked and corrupt of character and manners and dealings with the people, especially their families. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم خيركم خيركم لأهله وأنا خيركم لأهلي. The Prophet ﷺ, in this authentic hadith in the Sunan of Ibn Majah, which is graded as Hassan, the Prophet ﷺ said, The best of you is the one who's best to his wife, to his family. In a narration, it does say لِنِسَائِهِمْ. It does specify to the wife. And many of the translations here will take this to the wife. The best of you, a man, is the one who's best to his family, to his wife. And I am the best of you to my wife, to my family. Look at these examples. If we love Rasulullah ﷺ and want to implement his character, how come we cannot start with that basic, fair, good treatment of the wife and the children in the home? Or the husband and the children in the home? Other examples point out that we clearly need legislation from Allah and His Prophet ﷺ to do things correctly. Jum'ah is the best day of the week. As it was revealed, Jum'ah is the best day of the week. But, so many of us may think, well, it's the best day of the week, I want to fast on that day. But fasting was prohibited on the day of Friday if you do it alone, and you do not combine another day with it. You see, without learning your deen, and taking from the examples of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you cannot do things correctly. So we must always go back to the sunnah. On top of this innovation, more sin and innovation is added at this time, where you actually have those who say La ilaha illallah in one sentence, then go and call upon and make dua to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, or sing music and play music praising him, or make prayers to him. وَالْعَيَادُ بِاللَّهِ We seek refuge with Allah from that evil. So my brothers and sisters in Islam, don't do it. The only thing we have about his birth is that he said, because it happened on a Monday, فِيهِ وَلِدْتُ وَفِيهِ أُنزِلَ عَلَيَّ. The only thing we have is the Prophet ﷺ saying that on Monday I was born, and on Monday the revelation was sent down to me. And so because of this, the Prophet ﷺ, to thank and show gratitude to Allah, he fasted Mondays on a weekly basis. So we just surely know that it was on a Monday. So if you want to commemorate his birth and the revelation of the Quran, then you can fast on Mondays, and this is how you honor it. Again, going back to the sunnah. Ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu, he said, Al-qastu fi sunnah. خَيْرٌ مِنْ اجْتِهَادٍ فِي بِدْعَةٍ. Ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu, he said, moderation of the sunnah, to do the best of what was commanded of you, the best you can, as much of it as you can. Moderation in doing what was revealed for you to do is better than going the lengths with energy and effort in in innovation, in bid'ah and innovations. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, whoever recites blessings on the Prophet ﷺ 10 times in the morning and 10 times in the evening, they will get the shafa'ah of the Prophet ﷺ. Allahumma salli wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad. 10 times in the morning, 10 times in the evening. And you can earn his shafa'ah on the day of resurrection. That is a sunnah that we were told in authentic hadith that Shaykh al-Albani he authenticated. How many of us send our prayers upon him? On the day of Jum'ah, where we're told to increase our salawat alayh, increase our prayers on the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and that Allah blesses him. Yet many of us abandon these sunnah. So how can we claim to love our Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? This is a deen we have that is specific. How to purify ourselves in the restroom, how to bathe, how to eat, how to leave our homes and enter our homes, how to enter our masajid and leave our masajid. What to say on every occasion, when you wake up, if you had a bad dream, if it's raining, if it's windy, if you hear thunder. All of these things, our deen was so specific. You mean to tell me in all of this, it was missed that we were supposed to celebrate the birth of our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? We have to be real. Treat it at least as a doubtful matter. At the very least, even though it is very clear that it is haram to celebrate it. And the way you love our Prophet ﷺ and you celebrate his life is by implementing the Quran and the Sunnah. But even if you wanted to call it doubtful, قَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ إِنَّ الْحَلَالَ بَيِّنٌ وَإِنَّ الْحَرَامُ بَيِّنٌ وَبَيْنَهُمَا أُمُورٌ مُشْتَبِهَاتٌ. Our Prophet ﷺ, he said, the halal is clear, the haram is clear. In between them is very few little gray matters that you may not know. لَا يَعْلَمُهُنَّ كَثِيرٌ مِّنَ النَّاسِ. Many of the people are not aware of those things. فَمَنَ اتَّقَ الشُّبَهَاتِ فَقَدْ اسْتَبْرَأَ لِدِينِهِ وَعِرْدِهِ. Whoever stays away from those doubtful matters has protected his deen and his honor. وَمَنْ وَقَعَ فِي الشُّبَهَاتِ Whoever falls into those doubtful matters, وَقَعَ فِي الْحَرَامِ they will fall into haram. So my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, from the Fatwa al-Lajna al-Da'ima, the fatwa of the body of the scholars, they have said, honoring the Prophet ﷺ and respecting him is by believing in all that he came with from Allah, following his sharia and aqidah, verbally, actively, and in character, and leaving all innovation in the religion. And from the innovations of the religion, without a doubt, is the celebrating of his birth. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Aqulu qawli hadha wa astaghfirullah li wa lakum. Idhu Allah yaghfir lakum. الحمد لله ثم الحمد لله الحمد لله الذي هدانا لهذا وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله الحمد لله غافر الذنوب جميعها إلا الشرك به والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين أما بعد My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, so many times we see something as good and we go into it without realizing that there is nothing good that came after what Allah and His Messenger Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam decreed and what they gave us of a deen to practice and to follow so that we could get to Jannah. No time more than any other time than the time we're living in do we need more than ever to go back to the Quran and the Sunnah of our Messenger Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Give up those things that you hear of that you may have done your whole life even and Allah will reward you. Follow the deen as it was implemented. Our Prophet ﷺ, he is constantly depicted as an evil person, as a terrorist, as a pedophile, والعياذ بالله. And these are all lies and hate, wickedness and slander. Some people go to the streets to protest this. Burning flags, destroying things. This is not from the character of the Muslim. To go to the streets and burn some tires or burn some flags or go and riot, or go and destroy a store, no matter what their stance is. This is not the way the Muslim who follows the Prophet ﷺ is supposed to act. Some, when they see these things, they say, well, this is the time of his birth. Let's get together and say sallallahu alayhi wa sallam 10,000 times together, or whatever it may be. An innovation, we just said, Ibn Mas'ud, one of the keenest to follow the sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ, he said that moderation in the sunnah, doing what was commanded of you, is better than even if you go the lengths in some innovation. Why are you looking for other ways to love Allah or love His Messenger ﷺ, or to earn Allah's love or the love of His Messenger ﷺ? It was all laid for us and it was made a very easy, simple way. This is what we need to be doing, learning every day, not just on His birthday. Because we're Muslims, inshallah, 12 months out of the year. And not just on that one day. This should be a constant clear message with us. It is a heresy, it's an embarrassment to mention and celebrate this one day when clearly Allah told our Prophet ﷺ that we only have 2 days for celebration. And when our Prophet ﷺ told us not to exaggerate in praising him like the Christians have the son of Maryam, Isa alayhi salam. So it's sad when we don't follow our Prophet Sunnah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and live this deen out according to the Quran and the Sunnah the whole year, as it was done by the companions radiyallahu anhum wa ardaahum. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, لَقَدَ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ لِمَنْ كَانَ يَرْجُو اللَّهَ وَالْيَوْمَ الْآخِرَ وَذَكَرَ اللَّهَ كَثِيرًا. Allah said, what means indeed in the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you have the best example to follow. For the one who hopes to meet Allah in the meeting with Allah and the last day and remembers Allah much. We mentioned the ayah in the beginning and we'll mention it again. قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهِ Say, O Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, to all of mankind, if you really love Allah, فَاتَّبِعُونِي Follow my sunnah, the sunnah of Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. فَاتَّبِعُونِي يُحْبِبُكُمُ اللَّهُ وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذَنُوبُكُمْ وَاللَّهُ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ If you really love Allah, follow the sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allah will love you and forgive you your sins And Allah is oft forgiving and most merciful. Allahumma ighfir lil muslimin wal muslimat, wal mu'minin wal mu'minat, al ahya' minhum wal amwat. Innaka antas sami'un qareeb al mujib al da'wat. Ya muqallib al qulub thabbit qulubana ala deenik. Subhan rabbika rabbil izzati amma yasifun wa salamun ala al mursalin walhamdulillahi rabbil alamin wa sallallahu ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in.